Hi everyone, Marine here for Lanfon. A few days ago, I shared this cute mushroom house showcasing the Merry Mice light-up kit. It was the very first time I was using LEDs and copper tape on a card, but I liked it so much that I wanted to create another light-up card. This card features the Frosty Fairy Friends stamp set. It's an oldie but goodie product, and it's actually my all-time favorite holiday stamp set. So let's see how I made this card. I first started by cutting a background panel using Sugar Plum cardstock and this snowy backdrop die. This panel was a little bit too flat to me, so I started by applying Wilted Violet Distress Ink on the edges, and I added a tiny bit of black soot to create more depth. To get a nice and pretty snow background, I stuck my panel on Pixie Dust cardstock and trimmed off the excess of paper. I love this white glitter cardstock, I want to use it all the time. As usual, I stamped my images on white cardstock using jet black ink and colored them using my alcohol markers. I don't necessarily stick to a color palette, but this time I wanted everything to be coordinated, so I used purples and pinks with touches of white, and I colored my tree to be silver. These images are from the Frosty Fairy Friends stamp set, but I will add some that are from other sets at the very end of the video. When the coloring was done, I cut the images using the coordinating dies. Next, I cut two borders out of Pixie Dust cardstock using dies from the Stitch Simple Wavy Border die set. I like to use those dies to create grass, snow or sand borders. I layered those borders and temporarily taped them to my snowy background. I placed the images to get a general idea of the scene and marked where the star should be using a pencil. I searched my entire Lanfon collection looking for the tiniest star-shaped die and found this one from the How You Been Christmas Cookie add-on set. I tapped this die right on my pencil mark and sent the panel to my die-cutting machine. And I also cut the same star shape out of the top of my Christmas tree. To get a more diffuse light and at the same time hide the LED, I stuck a piece of vellum at the back of the star. Next, I added the pixie dust borders at the bottom of my snowy panel, cut a card base out of Sugar Plum cardstock, and marked the star spot to know exactly where I should put the LED. Now I'm going to create the whole light-up mechanism. First, I cut a small piece of cardstock to make a sleeve for my battery. And I marked on my card base the place where I wanted it to be. Inside the sleeve, I marked a positive sign, and on the outside, I mark a negative sign. If you've never made a light-up card, don't worry, it's very easy. If I can make one, you definitely can make one too. I applied glue at the back of the positive sign and attached the sleeve on the panel. And you can see a positive sign on the battery. This side has to be facing the positive sign on the sleeve. Next, I took the copper tape from the kit and also a LED. It's barely visible, but the top is positive and the pointy bottom is negative. Drawing pencil marks can help to visualize the whole circuit. So from the positive sign on the sleeve, I draw a line towards the positive top of the battery. And from the negative sign on the sleeve, I draw a line towards the negative pointy bottom of the battery. This way, I know exactly where I need to apply the copper tape. So I start with the positive sign inside the sleeve and I go towards the LED spot. If I need to turn left or right, I just fold the tape on itself and continue. I cut the copper tape and gently rub it using my bone folder to make sure the connection will work perfectly. So the positive line is done. For the negative line, I start from inside the sleeve so the battery can touch it. I fold the sleeve and I continue towards the LED spot. Again, I fold the tape on itself when I need to turn left or right, and I cut the tape and gently rub it. Next, I remove the back paper on the LED and stick it on its spot, and I make sure to press it well. And now I just put the battery inside the sleeve with the positive sides facing each other. And that's it, the light circuit is done. Next, I applied 3 layers of foam tape to make sure that the light won't be on all the time. I removed the back paper and attached my panel. The first thing I attached was the tree because I wanted to see how it looked. And next, on the door of the house, I stamped the phrase push here. It's from the light-up kit that was released last week, but you can use a stamp from the push here stamp set that is from a previous release. I stuck it using glue dots, making sure the door was positioned on the battery spot. And then I attach the remaining images. I added clear shimmer on some spots, such as the windows, the star, the fairies' dresses, and tree ornaments. And next, I applied white nouveau drops on each branch. And of course, fairies need sparkly wings, so I applied white blizzard nouveau drops on those elements. For my sentiment, I first cut a banner out of pink cardstock using a die from the simple wavy banner die set, and white heat embossed the phrase Joyful Wishes on it. My seed needed more snow details, so I cut a few extra pieces using coordinating dice from the Frosty Fairy Friends stem set and glued them on the house. I adhered the banner using foam squares, and I love busy cards, I can help it, so I added some mushrooms and gifts here and there, and also lights on the house to complete the scene. And the last final touch was to add white highlights on the images to make them pop a little bit more. And my light up card is done. What do you think of it? Have you ever tried making one? I hope you like it and that you will give this technique a try if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching and have a very nice day. Bye!